Okay, Twitchlings. Oh, God, there's my crotch again. I'm wearing my Stranger Things pajamas tonight. Oh, yeah. Oof. Hang on, I'll fix that in a sec. Hello, Twitchers, Twitchlings, Twitcherinos, Twitchos, Twitchies, Twitchers, Twitchings, Twitchlets, and everything in between. We are drawing Batman tonight, which is nothing new for the stream. I have drawn Batman quite a few times at this point. Oh, thanks for the updated sub, Mark, and good morning to you too, sir. So I wonder how many times I've drawn Batman. So, okay, I remember when I first started streaming, I did a Batman drawing for, and it was like the 75th anniversary or 80th anniversary or something like that. So I did that. I did Batman Beyond, so that's two. I did the Tim Burton Batman, the big poster that I did over 2 days. And I did one for the Pattinson Batman. So that's at least four right there. Plus I did Batgirl. And I did Robin. I've done the Joker a couple times and Catwoman a couple times. So quite a bit of Batman on this stream. And I had something else in mind. Last week I kind of alluded that I knew what I was going to do, and my plan was something else. But then Kevin Conroy died on Friday. I thought, you know what, being the Batman fan that I am, and I reference Batman the Animated Series in class so often that it's almost become a joke at this point. So I figured I got to do a tribute drawing for Kevin. So that's what we're going to do tonight. It took me a while to decide what exactly I wanted to do, but I think I landed on something. So let's do it. Let's do some really loose sketching. I need to block in some of these ideas. How are you doing, Mark? I don't think I've heard of The Moon. You need to fill me in. Is that a movie? Bethany, hey! How are you doing? Eyeballing the shit out of this perspective, by the way. I probably will do a ruler when I ink it. Whether or not I'll actually figure out vanishing points remains to be seen. Did autocorrect try to change NASA to Anna? Anybody have an idea of what I am actually drawing here so far? Oh, shit. Well, sorry to hear that. I got COVID in August. I got it during our summer break, so like I didn't have to take time off work, but I also had no break. It didn't hit me super hard, though. How's it hitting you? For me, it wiped out my energy, but other than that, which was frustrating, but at least I didn't feel like hell otherwise, you know? Putting way too much detail in this because there's a reasonable chance I'm going to have to scratch this and do it again. I'm worried I'm drawing it too big. Am I doing this too big? I might be doing it too big. I'm going to think here. I am. There you go. It's not going to be the Wayne Tombstone, but it is based on the Wayne Tombstone. But the name on it will be different. How's your energy doing? Are you, did knock your energy out? Like I said, that was my big thing. I probably would have finished my my Volume 2 Combat Fairies about a month earlier if I hadn't gotten COVID. Because I had that week off, and that was going to be like, I was going to get so much done that week, and then instead I got nothing done. And then I was back to work and juggling schedule and all that stuff. Yeah, I'd watch a movie on the couch, and then I'd start feeling like, okay, and I'd be like, okay, maybe I'm doing better, and then I would stand up, and then I'd be like, nope. That ain't happening. Okay, I can't decide. I don't know what I'm doing here. See, I had the concept, I hadn't thought of the pose too much. Something like that. Oh, I don't know. Yeah, exactly. And it's just like it rushes through your entire body. You're just like, okay, now I feel sick to my stomach. Now I'm feeling a head rush. Now I have a headache all of a sudden. And I better sit the hell down. When did you test positive? How long have you been stuck with it? I was onto something with the previous pose, but I don't think I was giving him enough room. And now I think I've gone really off the rails with the second attempt. What's awkward is he can't perch on this thing like he would a normal building, because there's barely any flat surface because of this freaking cross thing sticking out of it. Okay, nice. All right, let's try this again. Before I put pencil to paper, I'm gonna stare at this for a second and try to think of it out. But whatever, look better. you watch much of the Batman cartoon growing up, Bethany? Welcome back, JC. It's been a while. How's the new job going? Yes, rest in peace, Kevin, old friend. Okay. Was it one DVD and one VHS? What were they? Yeah, okay, I didn't roll a tear on it, but it hit me. Like, this is like huge part of my childhood. Okay, I'm getting somewhere with this post. I know it, but I'm still not there. It's looking too ape-like. I should have posed myself or something. Actually, come to think of it, I do have. Of course, not only the. Hey, Billy. Yeah, and if I read a Batman comic, it's his voice that I hear. I saw a thing on TikTok the other day that was Kevin in live action with Tim Daly, who was the '90s voice of Superman. And they were like reenacting a scene from Dark Knight Returns. It was actually super badass. Okay, I don't know if it was the exact same VHS, Bethany, but I do remember having something similar to that. And I think I have a DVD. I think it was a stocking stuffer one year. That was something similar too. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go a bit more on an angle here. We're gonna see how much looser I'm getting here. Okay, so we're gonna get the head over here. That's one thing we're gonna do. We're gonna put the chest over here. Was it a yellow cover? With like big kind of block letters for the whole. Found it. As Billy would say, I'm starting to believe. There have been copies of that floating around forever, because I think they're all the royalty-free cartoons. I think it's why they do them. So, like, I think there's a few different studios that can put them out on DVD.
if they want to.
I don't know if there will be another regular voice of Batman, because even if they have another new series, which I think they're working on, whoever does that voice, like, he'll probably do it in that one show, but I don't know that there'll be another one that they keep bringing back for different iterations the way they did. It was just that version of the character was so well liked that even for reinventions, they're like, well, we gotta at least do the voice. And they occasionally strayed from it, I know, but still. Okay, I am liking the pose. I'm gonna erase his head though, just because it's such a mess. I can't really see what the hell I'm doing anymore. Here's a funny story about Betty Boop. My mom has a ton of Betty Boop merch. And it all started because someone, I don't know who, might have even been my dad, gave her something Betty Boopish. And then it started this whole thing where people just started getting her Betty Boop stuff for a while. Not so much recently. The only thing that's really stuck is Wizard of Oz, because she is genuinely a big Wizard of Oz fan. But for a while there, it was a lot of Betty Boop stuff coming my mom's way. And I don't think she was ever really a big... I don't think she disliked her, but never really a fan. Betty Boop was your awakening. Well, that's... especially after I just told that story about my mom. Thanks for that, but... Another fun fact for Betty Boop. I don't know how you'll feel about this, JC, if she was your awakening, but... she was supposed to be a dog. Her original design, she was a dog. Which is why her head is shaped like that. Like, she's basically a pug. But they always had her on this really weirdly human-looking anatomy. And then eventually they just kind of adjusted the nose so it wasn't a black button nose anymore. And then she used to have kind of floppy-ish ears, but they kind of calmed those down a little bit. There you go, Chase. Yeah, I don't know what the backstory of that was. I think her first appearance, I'm pretty sure, was in a Popeye cartoon. I mean, that's kind of a cool interpretation. Not saying it was good that he killed them, just saying it's, you know, it's fiction. Play. I gotta look back. Hang on, let's do it this way. Still in touch with Jay, don't tell him I'm doing this. Vanishing points are for suckers. Ha! Kind of makes sense. Right, JC. Sorry. What's trippy, Bethany? The perspective, or referencing something I already forgot that I mentioned, which does sometimes happen when on these streams. Okay, I think I kind of made sense of that, but I'm gonna need to tweak the circular part. It's gonna need to do that as a whole, not in segments. Oh, yeah. Well, if I was really going to do this right, I would have to have the vanishing points, like, way the hell up there, and the paper is not big enough for that. And on occasion, I will, like, take pieces of cardboard and tape it to the side of the desk and stuff. I have been known to do that, but it's a bit much during a stream, you know. Or sometimes I'll figure it out digitally and then print myself out a guide. Also done this. Kinda, sorta ish. I can kinda get away with that, I guess. When I color it, there'll be dust and shit. okay, we also got this going on here. Cause we gotta get all that cool dark deco-y shit in here. Extra layers of stonework. Just knows to fuck up as far as my reference, but I'm taking some liberties. This is actually the Wayne tombstone after all, anyway. I don't know if I've seen that one, Bethany. I have seen there's somebody that does like crazy shit with string, who's wrapping it around like nails and stuff, and gets like pretty ridiculous results out of that. I'm kind of in awe of that. We haven't heard this track in a long time. This is that guy that's obsessed with Garrett. And we don't know who Garrett is. By the way, the keyword for tonight's playlist was mystery. are you planning to make for these Christmas gifts, Satane? Unless you're worried a reciprocant might be watching. Version of the bat symbol is probably the first logo I ever learned to draw as a kid. Still do it pretty much entirely from memory. I like the Superman logo. That one took a while to figure that one out. Because you'd think it's just an S and a triangle, but it's a very specific S in a very specific triangle. Some Gucci. Homemade Gucci. I'm just gonna run this right off the page, this cape. And I might extend it when I scan this to color it. But we'll see. I will be coloring this one. And since it's for a death tribute, I will be coloring it reasonably soon, I think. I forgot to look this up ahead of time. I need Kevin Conroy's birth year. November 30th, 1955. All right. I think I'm just going to do the year. There we go. All right. So that works. All right. Let's ink him. I mean, sorry, let's throw in some. Thank you. By the way, Billy, thank you, Billy, if I didn't say. So yeah, actually, just occurred to me, November 30th. So he was getting pretty close to his birthday, I guess, when he died. So he was 66, right? He would have been 67. Were they rounding up? I don't know. Math, like I don't math so much. I don't think this music has been all that mysterious, as the keyword would suggest. Because it's kind of tribal, isn't it? Kind of like background score for like a jungle scene, maybe. Oh, by the way, guys, I saw Wakanda Forever. I liked it a lot. So I'll just say it. I was gonna do something from that tonight. That was my original plan. And then Kevin went and died on us. And I felt like I had to do a Kevin drawing. Do it for Kevin. Don't intend to. Does that mean I'm doing good, or just because it's making you think of them in general? I saw a fan-made comic that was Batman and Commissioner Gordon, but Batman's not speaking, and he hands Gordon a note that says, "I've lost my voice." That got me. That needed a minute when I read that one. Right in the emotion berries. Oh, you saw that one as well, Mark? Like, that one was like, I mean, even if Kevin hadn't actually died, I think it would have been a sad comic. But then it's got that meaning behind it, and you're just like, oh god. Why are you doing this to me, internets? I think there was a really similar comic when some other voice actor died, and it might have even been another Batman actor, I think, but I don't remember, but I feel like I saw that same basic idea used when somebody else died at some point in the not so far off future, or past rather. Do we have favorite Batman animated series episodes, anybody? Oh yeah, that is a good one. The entirety of Batman Beyond. That was pretty good as well. I'm partial to On Leather Wings, which was actually the pilot episode. Man Bat, that one was just really, really cool the way that one was done. I think it might have been my animation awakening, actually, that episode. Because that first episode aired in primetime, and so I watched it with my parents. And there's that part where Batman's like got his like rope thing tied around Man-Bat's ankle, and he's like dragging him through the city, and he pulls him through a construction site. And I remember my mom being like, why doesn't he like grab onto one of those girders or something like that? And my dad's like, he's trying to. And just to see my parents get kind of into a cartoon enough that they would kind of have an exchange like that was kind of like, oh shit, like, you don't, this like, this isn't just for kids, this is serious stuff. Oh yeah, that is a cool one. Yeah, Yeah, that was also the poker game with Killer Croc.
It was a big rock.
And Heart of Ice, of course, but I feel like it's a lot of people's favorites. It's almost like the... It's almost like a cheat to say that one. Bethany, that video, the VHS of all the old cartoons, did that by chance have any of the old Max Fleischer Superman cartoons? If you're still with us, Bethany. Because those cartoons were pretty cool. And they also had a lot of influence on this version of Batman as well. I just realized you were asking him. I don't know the name of that episode, but I do remember. I think it's a Mad Hatter trick, isn't it? It's all like all in a dream or something. Right. Yeah. They also had a giant Godzilla-like dinosaur thing that like attacked the city. Before Godzilla was even a thing. Apparently those had an above average budget for cartoons at that time. It was like $500,000 an episode or something like that. That might be adjusted for inflation, I can't remember. My grandpa gave me a VHS tape, or maybe even a couple VHS tapes of those old cartoons, but I was really, really young, and I love Superman, but I didn't really get into them. And then years later, when I had a whole new appreciation for everything, because I was getting into animation, I kind of tracked them down again. We'll link the name later. I think Lois Lane, by the way, is an underrated character. Because, like, I think a lot of people think of her as, like, the damsel in distress. And I think, in some ways, she is responsible for that trope in comics a little bit. But the only reason she ever needed Superman's help was because she was brave enough to kind of go into all these dangerous situations for the sake of the story, right? And then the stuff that Superman would save her from would be stuff that anybody would need saving from. It's not like... It wasn't because she was helpless, it was because it was like a monster or a robot or whatever, you know. probably should have figured out he's Clark, but that aside. She's a product of her time in some negative ways, but I also think she was ahead of her time in some positive ways. Sorry, JC, sorry. I don't know what got into me. I bought a Batman comic today. Is that better, JC? Does that make up for it? Well, it's an Indigo. So, Sam Hamm, that wrote the 1989 Batman movie, wrote a comic that takes place after Batman Returns to kind of continue the Tim Burton version of Batman. And they released it in hardcover like a month or so ago, and I was going to wait till it was in softcover because I usually like my comics in softcover better, but then they were talking about it on a podcast, and the hardcover, if you take off the dust jacket, the inside hardcover looks like a giant VHS tape, and I was like, okay, well, fuck that, I gotta buy that. So I got that. So it's called Batman 89, but because it's set after Batman Returns, it's really more like Batman 95, I guess, but whatever. I actually like Batman was like my favorite as a kid, but I barely read any of his comics because I was always more of a Marvel kid. Batman was kind of the exception, and Superman a bit because I was so into the Superman, the Christopher Reeve movies when I was little. But but then when I got older and I started buying graphic novels, then I got caught up on some of the big Batman ones like Long Halloween, Hush. The only like mainstream comic I've ever bought the entire run from is the New 52 Batman with Scott Snyder and Greg Capullo with the Court of Owls and all that kind of stuff. I have some complete runs of indie stuff of a few different ones, but I think that's the only like mainstream superhero one that I've ever got the entire run from. Is Gotham Academy about Bruce Wayne as a teenager? Is it like Smallville but Batman? I remember like Kevin Smith like pitching a show like that years ago. Like I don't know if they ever formally pitched it to Warner Brothers, but like in the on their podcast. No, okay. Well then never mind. perspective, though. I might do some... I might do a little bit of surgery when I scan this. We'll see. I feel like the base is pretty solid, but this cross is... By the way, guys, on the topic of comics, Bethany's been doing a webcomic called Space Coyote. Or not Space Coyote. Space Kangaroo. Space Coyote is actually the handle of a different artist. And it's pretty cool. Welcome, welcome. Deserving of a shout out. Well, I fucked that up, but whatever. No, actually, you know what? I can fix that though, because it's got that edge is gonna be blacked out anyway. No one will be the wiser. It'll look like shit, but once I finish inking, it'll be fine. It'll totally be fine. No one will know. Except for you guys, but you're not going to tell anybody, right? The name that I said for a second, by the way, Space Coyote, is, that's a Vancouver-based artist that did a anime-style Simpsons fan art, and that got her a job doing a, issue of Treehouse of Horror that was going to be an anime parody. Oh, did they really? I didn't know that. Was there a specific reason they wanted to send a kangaroo up there? You could work that into your backstory. I feel like if that kangaroo jumped while in space, it may never be seen again. Was that in reference to the space coyote thing? Yeah, she had it on. She got discovered on DeviantArt. I don't know how likely that would be to happen again nowadays because, you know, there's just so much stuff on there. I think it was fairly early into DeviantArt being a thing. But yeah, she was a big Simpsons fan, did a fan art of them as anime characters. And then apparently she became a regular ongoing artist for Bongo Comics, doing Simpsons comics for a while. When I was reading that omnibus of Simpsons Halloween comics, I was disappointed that one wasn't, because I've never read that one. I'm only aware of it because she was given a talk at a thing I went to one time, the Writers Festival in Vancouver, and I figured that it would be in there, but I guess that'll be volume 2. I'm not sure what year she did that. Okay, what do you call a group of Batman? Or grip Batman. Or group, yeah. Wow. Also, I like how the dad joke brought out the Parker. What do you call Batman leaving church early? I don't know, Bethany. What do you call Batman leaving church early? Pretty good. This freaking tombstone done, other than all the spot blacks, but I'll save that. Music ended so abruptly. Why did Two-Face get his car towed? I don't know why. Ha! I see what you did there. Imagine if that was actually Two-Face's whole thing. You know, you didn't rob banks, kill people or anything, he was just parking illegally, and that's what made him one of Batman's greatest foes. I'll take it anyway. Well, Batman is telling her, no, no, don't you do it. Don't you do it. Yeah, that works. Why won't Joker take a motorcycle? Why? Oh yeah, JC, have a good night. So what's been your go-to to kill time type remedy, Bethany, since you got COVID? Lots of reading, lots of watching, lots of sleeping. Santane's still with us, we can sing the inking song. Okay, okay. That tracks. Applications for what? Or if you'd rather not share, that's also cool. We are live on the internet after all. Have you already beaten the game? least once before. Yeah. I got the impression when you told me before that you were maybe committed to that for a while, though. You maybe wouldn't be able to. Cool, cool. Change of scenery in general, let alone. Because where in Ontario were you from again? I think he told me, but I don't know my Ontario well enough. My parents are from Ontario, actually. My dad's from Ireland originally, but moved to Toronto when he was 7 or 9 at the oldest, I don't know. And my mom was born and raised there, and that's where they met. And then they ventured out this way when they got married. Drove through the States and up into BC in a motorhome. Law, Ontario. I remember a comedian was saying that something that all Canadians have in common is Toronto, because everyone hates that town. In Toronto? What were you doing? Were you working? Like, did you have to, like, face the COVID crowds and all that stuff? I was lucky in that we could teach from online, you know? Okay. Yeah, that's not a great situation. In terms of, like, the number of cases or just the way people reacted to it and stuff? Because I would say, I mean, like, we had a lot of cases. I don't know how it compared to other parts of Canada necessarily. If we were on the high end or on the low end. Probably better than Alberta. Fairly confident in that. And I mean, like, we had, but there was tons of, like, anti-mask and anti-vax protests and all that stuff. The lockdown, yeah, there, I mean, quite, I know there was quite a few businesses that went under because of it. Some that have been around for a long time. We had this really cool restaurant called, or restaurant and pub, I guess, called Stormcrow. They have two different locations, and their coolest location closed down. Because of it, which is unfortunate. Stormcrow is like a fantasy theme bar, fantasy sci-fi theme bar. And they have board games and stuff, so you go hang out, eat food that's named after, and drinks that are named after, like, geek stuff. And then, play different games and things like that. And it was really cool. And one other, like, one location is kind of just like a standard restaurant, but with, like, kind of geeky, decorations and stuff. And the other one actually felt like you were in a bar in Middle Earth. And that's the one that closed down, unfortunately, so we lost that one. Yeah, I don't know if I have, I don't think I have anything from Stormcrow, just memories. But there is that one location, so I guess stuff could still be bought from there. And then, of course, teaching online was really weird. Not an ideal scenario for anybody. And in the beginning, it was weird, too, because I think we were all convinced that we were only going to be online for, like, a couple weeks. And then all of a sudden, it became a whole year and a half or something like that. I think it was a year, then we were back on campus, but then there was another surge, then we were online again for a little bit. And there was a period where some classes were on campus and some weren't. A wooden beer mug, that's cool. Stein. Yeah. Especially, I would imagine kids would be a lot harder, too. Because kind of keeping them at attention that whole time. Which one's that, Billy? Turquoise Goat, that's a hell of a name. Why am I blanking on, there's the, what was the video game bar again that didn't last? Fuck, why am I blanking on that one? Went there a bunch of times. What were you teaching, by the way, Bethany? Also, we've lost our music. I think. Yeah, we have. Okay, one sec. Oof. Oh shit. Okay. That is the end of that playlist. Playlist is why I stopped. Let's just do this. We don't have a ton left anyway. EXP, right. I knew there was an X in it. What did that stand for anyway? Was that an abbreviation? Oh, okay. That's kind of boring, all things considered, but okay. Oh, like you actually had to go in person, you mean, at that point? Or, okay, gotcha. So you kind of became the... I think I know what I mean. How'd you feel about that? Makes sense. Huh. Wow. When people, like, there's like actual homeschooling books you get or something, right? It's like a teaching guidebook or something. To cover whatever like government mandated topics are or something like that.
Oh,
Oh, yeah. Well, especially because it's not, you're not giving it to a whole class, right? You're just giving it to one kid at a time. One of the weirdest parts of it for me was having like work blocks and stuff, especially because I teach a lot of technical stuff, like animation and different software and things, and kind of want to give people a chance to work on things while I'm around to answer questions. But in those blocks, it'd just be like dead air for like an hour or something. Because in person, when I do that, I'll like walk around the room and I'll chat people up. And if I see them struggling, I can jump in. But it's like it's on them to ask me a question when it's online. And a lot of people just, they're either not really working, so they're not discovering stuff they have questions for. Or they're too shy to ask, because it's almost like, because I get, you know, I keep my would keep myself busy during those periods doing something or other, but would always drop what I was doing to help somebody if they needed it. But it maybe didn't appear that way. They maybe were like, yeah, so it was weird. Yeah, well, I try to keep that one, because that one's a bit, because the normal VFS classes are 3 hours. So for that one, other than that, that first day we do the in-class exercise, and then I try to keep everything else me talking, largely for that exact reason. But I think any online class... hey, Louisa. Well, thank you, Bethany. Louisa is also from Story of Brand class. I don't think you guys were the same one, though, were you? I feel like Louisa was the group after you, Bethany. I just want to stay bad, stay mad, shit on my shoulder because they treat me like an outcast. I ain't gonna take that, stay back. I'll be swinging hard till the hits come in all caps. I ain't gonna lay back, pray that someone's gonna help me. Ain't nobody like that. I ain't gonna wait, that's all fact. Give me one shot and I'll never get the throne back. I'm sick of being cautious. I'ma go cause some pain, can't stop this. I'ma steal everybody's lane, call it shoplift. When did you do the storyboarding class, Louisa?
change into a better frame, into a better name. Society's insane, we all live for fame, yeah. Cash in the bag, stadium packed. Born a rock star in this life, gonna live it up on the attack. Baby, I'm bad, I just wanna get caught up in this life. I'm crazy, I'm mad, do it no cap. Only God wants you, better go live it up. Cash in the bag, stadium packed. Baby, I'm bad.
Yeah, not the best place. And now that you said that, Bethany, I'll assume that when you said how much you enjoyed the class, that was for my benefit. But it's cool. It's cool. Parker, when you got Kevin Conroy's autograph, was that the year that you were dressed as the Joker at Fan Expo? Or Riddler, rather? That's a... maybe Lori already told you, but at the Halloween party, she was Harley Quinn, Cam was Joker, Shannon was Poison Ivy, and Howard was Batman. So you totally could have been Riddler. Helped fill out that rogues gallery even more. Not guilt tripping you, right? Just saying. Well, I'm glad that I got you that excited, Louisa. I'm also glad you didn't quit your job. It's not a... certainly an easy gig to just walk right into, no matter what your skills are. But I'm excited that you want to go for it. Yeah, I remember you saying it. I barely got any notice for it as well. I mean, technically, I guess Lori mentioned it, I think, to all of us at, like, Cam's birthday, but that was, like at least 4 months ahead of time, whenever Cam's birthday is. And then I assumed it wasn't going to happen by the time it actually rolled around. I think I said before, but this music has Chloe Ting workout written all over it. on there now. Me? Not quite. Almost. Alright, now we're done. Let's sign it. Rest in peace, Kevin Conroy, from Batman himself. Thanks for watching, guys. Thank you, Billy. Back on Thursday, usual time. Thanks, Mark. I'm going to try to color this one sooner rather than later. I smudged it. My God. So maybe we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let's raid somebody. Let's see if we can find someone to raid. Actually, we couldn't get it to work last time, though, could we? Oh, shit. You can see my carpet clearly there. We'll attempt to raid somebody. We'll see why. We'll see if it lets us. Let's see who's live. Oh shit. You know what? Can you guys give me a suggestion? Actually, I got a Twitch thing. I can't actually check Twitch at the moment. But I can still raid them if I know the name of somebody. So is there an artist going right now? Make an animation? All right, let's do it. Raid has been created, so it worked this time. Here we go. And raid.